Hello, my fellow writing addicts. I'm Marissa, and today we're talking about sci-fi punk. Now, you might be wondering what that is. Well, it's a subgenre of science fiction that takes the nihilistic, rebellious ideologies of punk culture and apply them to a high-tech, dehumanized sci-fi world. Now, if you've heard of other genres like cyberpunk and steampunk, then you have heard of sci-fi punk because it's the umbrella term that covers the punk genre. So essentially, you have like science fiction, sci-fi punk, and then cyberpunk, etc. So yeah, I mean, it's also called punk, if that jogs your memory, but I really doubt it. But hey, you know, to each his own, I guess. So I do have a list of elements and tropes that show up commonly in these type of books, but when you get to the more specific ones like cyberpunk, then you're going to find more specific tropes. But those aren't on this list. You're going to have to watch another video for that, sadly. But I'm actually excited to do a steampunk or a cyberpunk list. That'll be fun in the future. So the first trope that I have is that the narrative and the world focuses on technology. And these are all going to be films, I'm sorry. I don't read a lot in this genre. And the example I have for you is Tron, where the whole point of the film is to explore, you know, being trapped in this digital world. I can't remember if it's a world or game, but you know what I'm talking about. The next trope is rebellion, which I think is just in a lot of genres, but especially in the sci-fi punk. And my example of it is Matrix, which is one of my favorite movies, where they have to rebel against the technology overlords that have enslaved us to be essentially used as batteries, which, you know, of course, fucking sucks. My next trope is also a fun one, where the protagonist is seedy, marginalized, and rebellious, and they live on the fringes of society, so essentially they're punks. So the next element is a gritty or transreal urban style. Now, what transreal urban is that you take fantasy, and then you take realism, and you combine them. And that's how you get that. And I think the perfect example of that would be the movie Ready Player One. So the next trope is a world that is built around a particular technology that is pervasive and extrapolated to a highly sophisticated level. I think the perfect example of this is in Terminator. You have the Skynet system, where it's like, just, it sees everything. It's that evil AI that runs the world. Just, yeah, I think no one has privacy, if I remember right. The next trope is a disillusioned, cynical protagonist that has to overcome overwhelming odds just to not have total defeat. And I think the best example of this is Elysium, where you have this poor guy who gets hurt and has to only can live, I think, like a few months, if weeks, if maybe even days. I don't remember, I apologize. And he has to wear this like exoskeleton suit just to walk around. And he, this one other like little girl, has to get up to Elysium just to survive. And obviously, total defeat would be death, which is just obviously tragic. Now on the flip side, you have these optimistic ones that just are filled with total badasses with these long coats, mirrored sunglasses, and just cool weapons. I'm going to go back to it because it's a fantastic film, Matrix. It's just, watch The Matrix, because that's exactly what it is. Oh, the movie's fantastic. Now, many of the subgenres focus on technology of a past era with a futuristic twist. A few examples of this is steampunk, which is an aesthetic blend of technology and the look and feel of Victorian England. If you need the one book reference I actually have is The Infernal Devices by Cassandra Clare. It's a little more hidden, where like you're not walking around with like goggles on their hats, but you'll see it if you read it, where the steampunk actually comes in later. Another example of sci-fi punk is, of course, cyberpunk, where the level of technology has risen to a high, high level, but the quality of life is still shitsville. An example of this is Ready Player One, which I'm sure most people have seen a movie. If not, you can watch a trailer to figure out where that kind of lends itself. Now, the last example we have is biopunk, which looks at the consequences of a biotech revolution. And I actually didn't know a lot about this, but it actually has one of my favorite movies in this subgenre, which is Repo: The Genetic Opera, which I think is fantastic. Go check it out if you want to like get a toe into biopunk. It does have singing in it, but I think that kind of elevates it instead of like brings it down. It's fantastic. Now, if you want to read in the sci-fi punk genre, we do have a few examples. We have Trouble and Her Friends by Melissa Scott, Hardwired by Walter John Williams, Snow Crash by Neil Stephenson, and Altered Carbon by Richard Morgan. And that's all I have for you today. Make sure you comment down below and please tell me your favorite sci-fi punk genre, like is it cyberpunk, steampunk, whatever have you, or tell me your favorite film or book under the sci-fi punk genre. I'm really curious. Also, if you want to talk to me, I'm on Twitter at writing_addicts, or at Facebook at facebook.com/writingaddicts. Also, please, please, please hit the subscribe button, hit that like button, and hit the notification bell. Please do all three, or at least one of them. Either way, you'll make my day. And as always, I'll see you in the next video. Bye!